Hello, welcome back to Bola's Cricket Crafts. This is Bola here. So today's tutorial is going to be a slightly different one. I'm going to show you how to resize an image on Photoshop. So usually when you go to upload your images on Cricut Design Space, it will give you an error with low resolution, and a lot of people wonder, how can I fix it? How can I change it? So I'm going to show you how to do that, and I'm also going to show you how to bulk resize images on Photoshop. So stay tuned for that. If you haven't already, please make sure you subscribe to my channel. In addition to selling SVGs, I also have an Etsy store, clip art store, where I sell loads and loads of clip art. I will link that in the description below, so make sure you check it out. Right into the training. So the first thing you want to do is to identify a folder that has all the images that you want to resize. Okay, in this case, I have a set of eyeballs clip arts that I sell. So I've removed the background. There's 16 of them. It's all ready to go. Okay, so in the base folder on your Windows Explorer or whatever platform you use, you want to create a new folder. So right click, new folder. And then you can name it Eyeball Clip Art 300 DPI, okay, so that you can know the difference between both. Obviously, one has all your images, the other one is empty. So go to your Eyeball Clip Art, right click on the first eyeball or one of your images, and then go to Open with Adobe Photoshop. You can also open Photoshop and import it, but this is the way that I find easy to do it. Now our image is open in Photoshop. So the first thing, if you just want to resize a one-off image and you're not resizing a whole set of images, all you need to do is to just go to Image, click Image Size, and then change the resolution to whatever you want the resolution to be, okay? And save your image and you're done. However, because we're doing a batch change, I'm going to show you how to do that. So the first thing you want to do is to go to your window and go to Actions, okay? And it will bring up a box on the right-hand side, okay? And you want to set the action that you want to do. And that's going to be your base action that all the other actions are going to copy. So press the plus sign, rename your action. I'm just going to call it resize. And then where it says set, instead of default actions, I'm going to call it 300 DPI and then press record. So from now on, any action you take, it's going to record it. So now I'm going to go to image and then change my image size. So, because my image is already 300 DPI, I'm just going to change them to 400 DPI, okay, which is even a higher resolution. So, I'm just going to wait for it to do its work. And once it stops whirling, I know it's done. Perfect. And you have to make sure your image stays within the gray checkered box, otherwise, it would just not come out right. Okay, so once that's done, I'm going to go to File and then I'm going to Save As, okay, because you want to save it into the new folder. Remember, you're trying to create the action for the other actions to copy. So go to the eyeball clip at 300 DPI, which is the second folder. Obviously, you can name it whatever you want, and then save. It would say save in the largest file size, which is the fastest saving, and okay. And on the top left corner, you will see a countdown to how many percent. And once that's done, you go to your file and then you close this box, okay. And now you go back to your window, go to Actions, and then you stop your recording. Okay, so now you've set your base action for all the others to follow. So to do the other resizing, go to your file, go to Automate and Batch, choose the folder, which is the base folder, which is your eyeball clip art. I need to make sure that I pick the correct one. So it's in my training folder, eyeball clip art, and select that folder. And then I want to choose my destination folder, which is the eyeball clip art 300 DPI. So I need to make sure that I also pick the right one. So make sure you keep an eye on the correct one as well. Otherwise, it will not work. And then click OK. And then you will see it would one by one resize all 16 images. When it's doing that, I like to just keep an eye on it as well, just to make sure that the images are appropriate, especially if they are AI generated. You don't want to make sure that you don't want to see some random foot in the eye or something random that shouldn't be there. So if that's there, obviously you want to delete that or edit it in whatever way you can. If there's some random background that hasn't been removed, I like to go and clean it. So once all your images have been resized and you've got your nice high resolution images, you can use it for your sublimation print. It's going to come out perfect. You can use it on Cricut Design Space. Your images are going to come out amazing. You can use it any way you want, really, and you have really nice high resolution images. So you can't really get 300 DPI from Canva. The only other way that I do it is on Inkscape, and that's not quite an easy or a straightforward process. It could be a bit more tedious. So this is the way that I found easy to do things, and I use it a lot, literally like 2-3 times a day, even if not more, for all my clip art in my clip art store. So I hope you've enjoyed this video, this tutorial, and you found it useful. If there are any other tips that you think that will be useful for us, please share below, and make sure you share it with somebody that you think it would be beneficial to them. Thank you, and I will see you in the next video.